Hi, welcome to the Tech Bytes podcast series brought to you by Tech Canvas. This is going to be a weekly series and we'll have interviews, concept discussions and certification preparation strategies on IIBA and PMI certifications like CBAP, CCBA, ECBA, Agile and PMP. In this episode, we have brought to you an interview with a business analyst and a talk on misconceptions about becoming a business analyst. The first one is an interview of Sohni, an ECBA certified business analyst. The interview is conducted by Rashmi Srivastava, a colleague of mine, who is a senior agile business analyst. She's going to talk to Sohni on her role and career as a business analyst. The second part of this episode will be a brief talk by myself on the top misconceptions about becoming a business analyst and why we should not be worried about these misconceptions. Rather, we should work hard to become a business analyst because that is a good profile and a good career to choose. So let's get started with the episode.
Hi all, a very warm welcome from Tech Canvas team to the session. In this session, we will have fruitful discussion with candidates who are working as a business analyst. We thought to have their experience shared with you and with few other business analyst aspirants who are listening to this session. I am Rashmi, a senior business analyst, having around 14 years of IT experience. I am an agile practitioner and I coach business analyst aspirants. All right. So for today, we have Sohni Suchendra, who is a business analyst and is an ECBA certified. Welcome, Sohni, to the session.
Thank you, Rashmi. Thanks for the opportunity.
And many congratulations on your ECBA certification as well.
Thanks a lot. Yeah, thank you.
Okay. So let us begin, Sohni. We have few questions for you. Mm-hmm. So, Sohni, can you tell us about yourself? When did you start as a business analyst?
Okay. So a brief background of mine, like educational background, I did my bachelor's in computer science. And thereafter, I completed my master's from European Business School, Germany. My specializations are like strategic management. It includes business analysis also. So after that, I was back to India and I started my career with the BA from 2019. Now I am working with Micron as a business analyst. So it's been 3 years for me. So initially, I started my journey with a startup. And now I have joined as a BA. As a BA, now I'm working with Micron Technologies, Hyderabad.
Wow, wonderful. So what does a typical day for you look like as a business analyst?
So it starts with retrospective things. So what had happened, like I have to check on with the technical teams, what they are doing and answer their questions according from the business need perspective. And it's like, so daily we have a stand-up calls and if the technical team has any doubts, we have to clear from the business need perspective. And also like we have a cross-functional teams and it's like having a liaison between the stakeholders. And if any developers have a doubt or something like that, we have to talk with stakeholders and get their requirement. And we have to discuss the same with the technical team. It's like we are the liaison between like every cross-functional team. Like I do work as the same.
Yeah, right. Okay. So, Sohni, as a business analyst, can you tell us two things you really like to be as a business analyst? You enjoy being as a business analyst.
Yeah. I really, really love being as a BA. Like because it's like every business you have to learn. You have to research from the scratch. If anything is going on happening, you have to learn from the beginning, like scratch, like why this, like the basic questions, like why, how, and what. What is the need? What is the want? You have to analyze everything. It's like gaining it so much of knowledge. And every day is like a kind of learning for me, understanding the business analysis, like from every perspective, how everything is going to change and how it had changed. It's like learning every day. So I really love being as a learner forever. So I consider myself as a learner. So it's like really helpful for me understanding the business in all the perspectives.
Yeah, and learning every day is, yes, it's so very essential for any job, I would say, any role, I would say.
Yes, yes. Basically, for a BA, it's like if you are like you have to give something in response to the stakeholders or any developers, you have every knowledge of what we are doing. I mean, what you are doing. It's not like, okay, stakeholders give these requirements and you have to impose the same with the developers. It's not like that. You have to have a basic research on what you are doing and then go to the stakeholders. And you have to listen to the stakeholders, what is the requirement and what is the scope of it, and then you will differentiate actually what is the need and what is the want, and then you will give a session to them, and it's like kind of retrospecting things, and you will be like a kind of that analysis phase is really very much worthy for everyone.
Yeah. So moving to the next question on the similar lines, and I believe that everything has its own cons and pros. So is there anything you really do not like about a BA?
To be honest, like not really. Yeah, because I really love enjoying that. Yeah, kind of we face like, although like every job has its challenges, I do agree that. But how we come up with the challenges, that's the main issue, how you tackle the situation. So yeah, it's all where BA comes there.
Wow. Yes. That's nice. So how do you keep update with the changes around you, Soni?
So personally, I do believe the Webhawk guide, it's really, really helpful for every, as a business analyst, because it has each and every content. If you need anything, information, or like if you want any, like what the stake, what is RACA matrix or any terminology related to that, it's really helpful. So I always do refer to that Webhawk guide, and any, like I do follow some of the guides in when I click on the Google.
Okay. So from now, you are already a business analyst. Where do you want to go from here? What is your plan for your future, your career ahead?
Yes. So next step, I really want to write the next level of CCBA exam, like after ECBA. So, and then I would like to go with the project manager role.
Okay. All the best for that, Soni.
Thank you very much.
And project management. Yes.
Thank you.
Do you believe that non-IT professionals cannot become a business analyst? If yes, then you must listen to this. I'm going to address top four myths or misconceptions about who can become a business analyst and what is needed to become a business analyst. One of the reasons for these misconceptions is the fact that business analyst role is into the IT industry, and it's quite natural to associate technical or programming skills with this role. So let's look at these four misconceptions. Let's start with the first one. One must have an IT background to become a business analyst. So not true. There is no such mandate or condition in the IT industry. At Tech Canvas, we have seen several hundreds of non-IT professionals becoming business analysts. These professionals were from travel, banking, insurance, technical writing, airlines like non-IT backgrounds. So how did they do it? There is a structured approach for becoming a business analyst. I'm going to provide two links in the description. One video is going to talk specifically about how to become a BA and a roadmap for the same. The other one is my interview with an air hostess who became a business analyst, and now she is working with a top financial company in the United States of America. The second misconception, one must have domain knowledge to become a business analyst. Now, it is true that domain knowledge is important for every business analyst, but that does not mean that you need to have domain knowledge to become a business analyst. The entry-level business analysts could be generalists who don't need to have any specific domain knowledge like on banking, on insurance, or any similar such domain. There are specific roles even, like UAT coordinators, where stakeholder collaboration and BA skills are enough to qualify you for that particular role. Now let's talk about the third one. You must learn Python, Tableau, and R to become a business analyst. Now this impression has developed because of the general nature of the term business analyst. Business analyst is used in several contexts. It is used in the data analytics world. It is used in the consulting industry. It is also used in specific software application initiatives. Please note that tools and skills like Python, Tableau, and R are only required if you are going to work in the data analytics or business analytics domains. Otherwise, these are not required for a business analyst. So, what do you need to learn to become a business analyst? Well, some of the key skills which are required are requirements elicitation, agile-related skills and techniques, UML modeling, SDLCs, etc. Now, finally, the last one. Cracking a certification will ensure a job. Again, far from the truth. Certifications are useful, but there are two primary reasons for the certifications. One, in the job search, certifications help in differentiating your resume. That means that you have better chances of getting your resume shortlisted. Secondly, the IABA salary surveys, both for 2020 and 2019, suggests that getting certified does help in gaining confidence and performing better at job. So do the certifications for the right reasons. Certifications do not equal jobs. These were some of the most common misconceptions about business analyst profile. I must add, though, that the business analyst is definitely a good profile and has a bright future. So please go ahead, but remember, there is no shortcut. Thank you for listening to me. Thanks for listening to this episode. Next week, we'll come back with few more interesting topics. Thanks again.